What a game. First of all, I gotta acknowledge our fans. Our fans were off the charts. I mean, it was deafening in there. It was extremely loud, and so you got to take your hat off to them because they brought it. They brought it for us tonight, and you can feel the energy. My son Elijah told me when he got to the building, he texted me right before the game. He said, "Dad, the energy in the air is unbelievable." And this is before tip off. So, you know, I applaud our fans. We're going to need them to continue to be there for us night in, night out, because it's not easy. It's a long journey, and we just got to keep taking it one step at a time. And we need everyone behind us in Sacramento, which I feel we definitely have. I thought our guys, they competed. They stayed poised, especially when we went down. Golden State, again, they're champions. And, you know, you're going to have to try to take this from them. You know, it's not going to be easy. They're good. They're going to go on runs. We may go on runs. And we have to stay the course until that buzzer sounds at the end of the game. So for our guys to do that, even when we were down, was fantastic. Obviously, Foxy and Malik were terrific for us. You know, they both hit the record books for playoff debuts. Obviously, Malik coming off the bench and his point production for a playoff debut, and Foxy, obviously starting and him having a playoff debut. They were big for us, especially when we couldn't get a bucket during the course of the game, and that's what you need. You need guys to step up, especially you need your all-stars like Foxy did tonight. He was absolutely fantastic. I thought our physicality on both ends of the floor was good. Our pace was good in the second half. We ended up scoring 10 fast break points in the second half, which was a huge difference than what we had in the first when we only had two. And, you know, again, I'm going to be preaching that the whole playoff run. Physicality, pace, physicality, not just in the full court but in the half court too. And physicality, not just defensively but offensively as well. And speaking of offense, I thought our sprays changed the game. We did a better job in the second half of touching that paint and finding guys on the perimeter. We had a lot of guys hit some big shots for us. But I also have to give credit to the rest of our bench. Our bench was really good. Davion, Trey, and Alex. I already talked about Malik, but those three guys were really, really good for us in a lot of different ways. It's one game. Obviously, we'll take it, but we understand that this is a long journey.
Coach, congratulations. Sounds like maybe some country music and Modelo are in order tonight. I don't know, but what can you share with us about the way you defended? Steph didn't get a very good look there. I know it was a very short clock, but what can you share about the way you defended their last shot and where that broke down for them?
Well, I mean, he's capable of making any shot, and you just kind of hold your breath until that thing bounces off the rim. You know, it's no secret we wanted to take away the three-point line, and that's what we tried to do. But in the same breath, he's so crafty that once he faced up, you know, you had to try to contest but not to do it where you're picking up a foul, because if you foul him in that situation, we all know he's making all three free throws. He's about as good a free throw shooter in the history of the game as anyone. So, again, we guarded the three-point line. We did a fairly good job with it. He ended up breaking free at the last second. He had to rush taking that one-foot three-point shot, which at the end of the day you got to live with as opposed to fouling him.
Mike, Matt George, UBC 10. Over the course of the season, a couple times you talked about you can't always call timeouts to regather the group. You need them to do it yourself. How pleased are you with how they responded to Steph and Clay's kind of big shots in the fourth quarter to make sure things didn't get out of control?
No, I'm excited. We had an extra timeout to burn, and, you know, it was close, you know, not just to stem the tide a little bit, but I thought our guys would, especially Foxy, because we ran them, would need need a quick blow. But we kept, you know, mixing in stops with big threes that they hit, and we were pushing it. And I did not want to hinder our pace at all. And that's why I didn't burn, that's why I didn't use extra time out, because I thought every time we got it off the glass, and even after the makes, we were trying to get it up the floor, and I didn't want to take that away from them, because that's how we're going to have to play throughout our playoff run.
James Hammett, ESPN 1320. Mike, we've talked about it all season long with you. You started early in preseason talking about how De'Aaron has to be a two-way player for you guys.
Yeah.
The 38 points was nice, but his defense tonight was probably some of the best we've seen in his career. Just like, what has gone into that, making him that type of defender?
Well, first of all, he's embraced it. He knows that he has to be able to do that in order for us to attain or achieve our goal. He's got to be a two-way player if he expects at all, at any time, to win a championship, and he's got to do it at a high level. He was really good tonight. You know, we try to give him a rest from time to time by throwing Davion in the game and letting Davion chase Steph around. We also mixed in a little bit of zone and boxing one, and we're going to have to keep trying to mix it up, you know, throughout the course of the game. But he's going to have to be not only elite for us offensively, but elite defensively. And that's what an all-star does. That's what a first, second, third team all-NBA player does. They rise to the moment, especially when the moment's really big.
Like we know Malik right here. We know Malik's got a big personality, and when he plays, he's always aggressive and getting his shots up. But to see what he did tonight, what'd you make of that, particularly in his playoff debut, and how much does his personality rub off on his teammates when he is encouraging guys, and particularly guys off the bench, to do what they do?
Malik is a confident individual, and you can feel that when you're around him. And, you know, I told him there were a couple of times where I thought he touched that paint, and he had a couple of sprays in the first half. And I told him, I said, Malik, I said, I'm not trying to call you off your shot. I'm going to live with you shooting the ball. But when you touch that paint, if you can feel it, we got guys wide open on the perimeter because they're either A, trying to blitz you, or B, and so they're sending two at you, or B, they're sending a second, sometimes a third body when you hit that paint. I said, now, again, I know you can score, and if you don't agree with what I'm saying, you do what you want to do, and we're going to live with it. And, you know, you could feel Malik's confidence, and we need that in games like this, because he ain't afraid of me, and he ain't afraid in a moment, which is what we need.
Coach, Mark Devon, Davis Enterprise. Third quarter, the scoreboard showed you guys missing 18 of your first 22 three-pointers. You guys end the game making 8 of your last 10. Talk about that turnaround, how you made it happen.
Well, we can shoot, and I told our guys, I thought we had some wide-open looks in the first half that we normally make, and they just didn't go down. And so we kept encouraging our guys, if you're open just even a tad bit, let it fly. We got to play fast, and if you're open, let it fly. If you pass up a shot to drive and all that other stuff, we'll probably get a worse shot. So trying to instill that confidence in our guys, even when we weren't shooting it well, was big by my entire staff and our vets, because they kept letting it fly, and we finally, you know, caught fire enough to knock a few down towards the end of the game.
Mike, Jake Eden from CBS 13-1. Did anybody win the chain?
Alex Lynn.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah.
And two, you said you'd need everybody when this playoff run hits.
Yeah.
Domas, Keegan struggled a little bit tonight. What do you want to see of them when they take on game two on Monday and changing their game and their approach?
But in this situation, you got to have a short memory. That's the biggest thing. You got to have a short memory. They've done it all year for us, and so we're going to keep encouraging them to play their game. If they are in position to score, go ahead and do your thing. But don't hesitate at all. If they hesitate, that's what would hurt us more than anything else. We all have confidence in them.
Tony Harvey, NBC Sports Radio. Coach Brown, you know, you've been pretty much preaching about mental toughness all season. That fourth quarter fury, would you describe that, you know, as something that, you know, that your team just upped the level and just rose to the occasion?
100%, you know, and more so Throughout the course of the game, especially when we were down, when we were down again, not being in a situation like that when the stakes are as high as they are in a game like tonight against the defending champions, you could have easily said, hey, we got seven games to win four. It's okay if we don't get this one. Let's fight and figure it out for the next game. But our guys mentally stayed locked in and kept trying to do the things that we asked them to do by being physical, on both ends of the floor, and getting out in transition and trying to increase our pace, especially in the half court. So that takes a mental toughness as well, and our guys showed it tonight.
Mike, Jason Anderson, Sacramento Bee. I asked you a week or so ago what playoff Fox might look like, and you said you wanted to see it first.
Yeah.
Now that you've seen it, I just wonder, what is it about his makeup, his skill set, what you know about him that might make him able to thrive in these kind of environments?
His skill set is off the charts. He can shoot threes. He's got a medium game. He can get to the rim. He can get out in transition. Things he does offensively, he's so shifty and crafty, and he hits difficult or tough shots. It's really fun to watch, and, you need guys like that on your side because, again, they know everything that we're throwing at them. And so there's no secrets. You got to have guys on your team that can go make plays. And Foxy went and made plays tonight, and that's just a testament to who he is. What a playoff debut. You can't ask for much more than what he did tonight. The biggest thing, though, that I felt and that I continue to see from him is, in order to be great, you have to have a short-term memory. All the greats that I've been around, hey, they move on to the next play. Next play speed, baby. And Foxy did it. I think he had 9 points. He was 3 for 8 in the first half. And that did not hinder him. And that was fantastic to see.
Yeah, Coach, Brendan Nunes, Kings Herald. That box and one that you mentioned, we saw a lot of in that second half. What allowed your team to be successful in running that, and how well do you think they did of going in and out of that coverage as you called for it from the sideline?
They did a great job, and we don't work on it a ton, and it was part of our game plan as coaches going into this series. And I won't forget, we were in the coaches meeting, and somebody said, hey, let's work on the box and one, let's work on this, let's work on that. I said, no, we're not going to, because the beauty of us going to a box and one is we don't really know what we're doing, which that may confuse the other team. So let's just let them play. And to back that up, when we were slapping the guys' hands going around, Alex Lynn, first thing he said to me, he said, Coach, hey, can we go over the box and one? Because I don't know what I'm doing. I said, that's a good thing. Don't worry about it. And I kept it moving. So we have some principles, but the biggest thing is we just got to talk or communicate with one another, cover space, and if somebody gets cracked, then you go ahead and switch it.
Michelle Depper, KCRA. Coach, Harrison Barnes called this an emotional win. What do you think this win means for a guy who's been through the highs and lows of this franchise?
Means a lot, and not just for him, but it means a lot to all those guys because, I said this before, when you have a team that is inexperienced in a lot of different areas, you got to find little victories and celebrate them just so that they can continue to believe. And the more belief they have, that's the more dangerous that team becomes. And so getting this win for sure is an emotional win, especially with us being down with the defending champions in game one. And hopefully that's going to give us a little bit more confidence going forward.
Yeah, Coach Sarah Hodges, CBS 13. Just to go off that, just to be able to come up victorious in game one against the Warriors, how huge is that, as well as just building that confidence?
It's huge, you lose a game and doubt can start creeping in to certain guys, especially guys that haven't been on this stage yet. You're playing against the defending champions and so on and so forth. And so when you can go out there and you can get a win, especially in game one, especially at home, that always helps the psyche going forward.